the Lab-RAT-ory. I wanted to make this video for those of you who mentioned that you were interested in finding out some of the specific things that you will need to do such a thing. My advice is the more research on the matter that you do, the better off you are going to start taking these kinds of photos. It's not as difficult as it seems appears to be, but you are going to need some materials and products that I think are indispensable, beginning with, of course, a strong tripod. It doesn't have to be the most expensive tripod, but avoid the cheaper tripod, because it's just gonna, you're gonna be risking your camera, and depending on how much your camera costs, then I think you should have as good a tripod as humanly possible. I have several from way back when I started taking photographs, so I have heavy ones, plastic ones, cheap ones, throwaway ones. I have a whole bunch of them, and I use them. I also have these light stands that you can get to for like $18.95 or $22.95. I don't know what brand. Oh, newer. There is the brand right there. Newer, and they've served me very well. And you can, you can do all kinds of neat photography with those stands. The other thing that you are going to need that's very important, it's a flash. And in this case, I love these Young Newell speed lights, YN568EX2. You could see them there. And they give you, amazing versatility. This is a Gary Fong light diffuser, okay? And this is a snoot with a grid. This one helps you concentrate the light. This one helps you get a very soft, light that spreads everywhere. This is great for on the run portraits, and it's just fantastic. And both the Young Newell flashes you can get very cheap, probably for under less than $60. The Gary Fong is expensive, and I don't know if there's an alternate. I'm sure there is. And but again, you can play around with the, you could do a DIY on these, and build your own. So the other thing that you are going to need with the Young Newell are basically a transmitter, a control transmitter, and a trigger. These two speak with each other, and you can get them in sets. And again, these are the Young Newell YN622C TX, and then this is the YN622C. You can see it there. So, and these are good to have around. The other thing that you are going to need is this beautiful piece, of plexiglass. That you can see here, it's like, ooh, you could do all kinds of neat effects out there. But anyway, I got this in shiny black. It'll get scratched up, but it's fairly cheap, and it doesn't have to be round. You could go square, but I just thought the round really, because I put it on top of a stool, so this was gonna work just fine for me. And that's pretty much it. I haven't spoken about cameras because I think you can do this kind of photography with a cheapy camera that does flash photography, and as I said, read up and research as much as you possibly can. Speed lights are wonderful because they do allow you to control the light, and also not only the flashlight, but more importantly the ambient light. And this is how you're able to drop the ambient light down all up to very dark, and then the flash concentrates the light on the model. So it's a way of painting. I've done it also without a flash, by simply using a flashlight and then bringing the speed of the shutter down to, you know, to 10 seconds, something like that, and you quickly, that gives you enough time to take the flashlight and paint the model. And so these are fun techniques that you can do and have fun with. So I encourage everybody to try it. And as you can see in this video, you know, there'll be some results. Some are better than others, but then you can come into Photoshop and clean up the little dust specks, and you can do all kinds of fun stuff. Add some really neat typography to the name, with the name of your model, all of that. So, I mean, when I first started, I thought these kinds of things were out of my reach, and I just spent enough time looking at how-to videos, and I got a couple of also photography books and things like that. I mean, I've been photographing as an amateur hobbyist for a long time, and I just wanted to have a little bit of fun, since I'm already building models. And also the fact that if you're building models, you know, take a little bit of pride and try to photograph them in the best light. And so this is fun. It's all fun. And again, you don't have to do this kind of thing. You could take your model outdoors and find neat backdrops upon which you can photograph and have a blast. So enjoy the adventure, enjoy the learning process, and let me know what you think. There'll be more videos coming up. All right, my friends, stay tuned in.